Good morning, everyone. This is Mike of MLB Accounting, wishing you a happy Monday. Today's episode is a continuation of our topic last week, which was about the advantages of setting up an SMSF or a self-managed superannuation fund. The main advantage is the control you can have in an SMSF, the tax advantages, and the cost efficiency, especially if the balance is huge. Bearing these advantages in mind, I had an animated discussion with one of our clients whom we have set up an SMSF 2.5 years ago. He said that he was comparing notes with his friend who is in an industry or retail super fund. He said that his friend looked at his previous statements and said that it only has a 3% annual growth, and if you remove the 1.5% admin charges, then that only leaves him with a 1.5% growth per annum. This is not even enough to cover real inflation of 2.44% in 2018. By comparison, our client said that when we set up his SMSF in mid-2016, he started with $200,000, purchased a property for $450,000 in December 2016 by borrowing the balance from the bank. As of June 2018, the property is worth $650,000. Since the home loan for the property is still $250,000 plus a buffer of $50,000 in the fund, his net position in the fund is $450,000 or 225% of the initial balance of $200,000. You can see that the 125% growth in the SMSF is definitely more than the 1.5% growth in the retail or industry super fund. If the difference is so glaring, then why isn't everybody doing it? The answer probably is that the big banks do not want you to manage your own retirement fund. These banks control the super funds and can also lobby the politicians into enacting laws favoring their interests. This is why setting up an SMSF and taking out home loans via the SMSF is getting tighter and tighter. No big banks are allowing SMSF to borrow funds. Only the second-tier lenders are doing it. Running your own SMSF is under very tight scrutiny through annual audits and strict regulations, whereas the super fund in retail or industry can get away with making their employer and voluntary contribution seem like part of the fund's growth. This is in some way deceitful. Currently, there are a good number of retirees whose retirement funds are not enough to pay them a decent pension. Hence, they need to go back to working. The superannuation program was set in the 90s with the projection that the average return would be 8%. I did not take into account that the funds would be charging a huge amount. Also, not many professionals in their 30s or 40s think about retirement. Retirement planning falls into the second quadrant of the time management matrix, which is, it is important, but for most of us, not urgent. If you don't look after your retirement, who will? Can you confidently say that these super funds are here to prioritize your interests before theirs? If so, why do they spend a huge amount on advertising to join them? Have a conversation with your partners about retirement and interview retirees and find out if their super funds are enough for them to retire. Take the time to look into this. It is your future anyway. If not now, then when? Please bear in mind that it is important that you should always get a professional advice in dealing with your super fund and in setting up an SMSF. Again, this is Mike of MLV Accounting, and I will see you again in the next episode. Happy Monday, and let us start the week right with today's Monday lesson.